Hare Krishna. The capacity to trade the present for the future is the defining human characteristic. All of us live in a world where all living beings live for the present. So, for example, every living being, when they feel hungry, they look for food. When they feel afflicted by the desire to mate, they look for a mate. So these are where in the present we get a desire and we seek something in the present. And we human beings are also no exceptions for this. But there is an exceptional ability that we do have. And that exceptional ability is that we have the capacity to trade the present for the future. That means that we can understand that we as living beings, that if we give up something in the present, then we can get something in the future in return. And we can get something much better in the future in the return for giving up something in the present. And this is the basic principle of sacrifice. So it's like a trade, but it's not a simple trade. In a normal trade, we give up something in the present and we get something in the present. But a complicated trade often involves that where we need to give something now and in return we will get something later. So for this, what do we mean by the capacity? If we look at human beings in any field that we have progressed, it is because of understanding this. That right now, we could have just eaten food, and Newton, when he saw the apple falling in front of him, or as some people say, on his head, whichever way, when he saw the fruit falling, apple falling, he would just have grabbed it and eaten it and gone on his way. But instead, he reflected, what made this apple fall? And maybe understanding this mechanism, it required some deep thinking, it required some inspiration, it required some further research and experimentation. But that willingness to delay gratification led to his being able to do something much more valuable, discover the theory of gravity. And the joy of discovering that theory and the benefit in terms of technological advancement that humanity has been able to have because of that, they are unparalleled. They are at least in recent modern history. And this applies to every field. For example, when we study language. Now, babies just utter some sounds and they, by crying, by laughing, they communicate some things. But to apply themselves to learn language properly, it requires effort. When they put in that effort, then they get a rich reward. And once the language is learned, then so much deeper emotions and deeper concepts can be communicated, which is just not possible to communicate through various kinds of non-linguistic sounds. And this principle also applies to a spiritual life. In fact, the principle of yajna, sacrifice, is where we give up something that is enjoyable in the present so that we can get something far more valuable in the future. That is the defining characteristic of human life. And if we are ready to give up some temporary pleasure in the present, temporary sensual pleasure in the present, then we can get eternal spiritual joy in the future. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita in 3.9 that we need to perform yajna. That yajna, when we perform, then by that performance of yajna, then we will become purified. That to the extent the work that we do is yajna, to that extent we become liberated. And if we don't do yajna, then we stay bound. So this principle, if you understand, this is our unique human strength. The capacity means we have firstly the intelligence to perceive that reality is structured in such a way that we can perform trade with it. And ultimately, reality is not just like an impersonal mechanism. There is a personal being beyond it. And when we sacrifice to that personal being, to the Supreme, in a mood of devotion, then we can get rich returns. By sacrificing something that we love presently, we can get eternal love. So the intelligence to perceive that, and then thereafter the willpower to pursue that. That, okay, once I have decided, I can do this, that if I do this, I will get a bright return, then to pursue that. Both this intelligence to perceive and the will, and the willpower to perceive, to perceive and pursue. This we have got, this is what defines our humanity. And to the extent we tap this gift of humanity to perceive and pursue the capacity of trading the present for the future, to that extent, we can use our present human life, even if it is temporary, to attain an eternal spiritual life. Thank you. Hare Krishna.